بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد, we get these questions a lot about Taraweeh, Salat al-Taraweeh. Some people now, they come with shak and shubuhat. Some of the people said this is a bid'ah, this is innovation. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam never made Salat al-Taraweeh. And some people, they say Salat al-Taraweeh can only be 11 rak'at, yani 8 rak'at of Taraweeh, and then Shaf Witr 3 rak'ah, 11 rak'at. And they said that 20 rak'ah is a bid'ah. And some other people, they said that Salatul Taraweeh can only be 20, yani 23 with Witr. 23 rak'ah and 11 rak'ah is not Sunnah, this is Qiyamul Layl, this is not Taraweeh. 20 rak'ah is where there is Ijma of Sahaba and Umar radiyallahu anhu, and whoever does Khalif to it is doing bid'ah. But all of these aqwal are based without ilm. So we wanted to address some of these issues to clarify, inshallah ta'ala, with the clear evidences from Sahih Ahadith, so it will be clear, it's day like it's night, and it's night like it's day. The first thing, can we say that there is the praying of Taraweeh as the word Taraweeh mentioned in Hadith? No. The word Taraweeh is not mentioned in the matan of any Hadith. What is Taraweeh? It is the Qiyamul Layl for Ramadan. What you call Tahajjud, what you call Qiyam fil Layl, that night prayer, when you make it in the month of Ramadan in Jama'ah, we call it Taraweeh. Imam Bukhari has a bab on it. But this is a term given to tahajjud for Ramadan. When you make Qiyamul Layl in Ramadan, there are special virtues. And you do it in Jama'ah. Regularly all year, you don't make Qiyamul Layl in Jama'ah. If you call the people to come together to make Qiyamul Layl in Jama'ah, other than Ramadan, this is a bid'ah. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do it that way. But he did in Ramadan, so if you do it in Ramadan, we call it Taraweeh from the breaks and rest that we give for the people. Tayyab, so is that a bid'ah? First and foremost, we see that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the hadith that is reported in the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, he says, فَمَنْ قَامَ الرَّمَضَانِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا قَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ. يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى غفر له ما قدم من ذنبه. يعني لا قدم تقدم. هذا هو حديث صحيح في صحيح البخاري. What did Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell us? That if somebody stands, he makes Qiyamul Layl in Ramadan, he prays this, what we call Taraweeh, and Imam Bukhari has this under the bab of Taraweeh, then Allah will forgive his earlier sins. In another riwayah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, who prays with the Imam until he finishes. Yani, so this tells us that from the Sunnah Qawliya, from the Qawl of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, Taraweeh Sunnah. Tayyib, in the same book, Sahih al-Bukhari, we find the hadith reported by Aisha radiallahu anha, that she says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came out for that laylin, in this night, fil masjid, for salla bi salatihi an-nas, yani the people prayed with him that night. And then the second night, and athaniya wa thalitha wa rabi'a, yani for continuous, he used to come out, and he made jama'ah with the people in Ramadan, Qiyamul Layl, what we call Taraweeh. And then either on the third or fourth night, he didn't come out. And then Aisha radiallahu anha, she says, the people waited till the morning. And when the morning came, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came out and he told them that nothing prevented me except that I didn't want it to become fard upon you. And it's not that this is a bid'ah, but he didn't want that people take Taraweeh to be fard. And then the Rawi Aisha radiallahu anha, She continues in the hadith that this continued during the time of Abu Bakr and the time of Umar. Yani in the Khilafah of Abu Bakr and Umar, this practice continued. So from Sunnah Fi'liya, from the action of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we see that Taraweeh is Sunnah. Taraweeh Sunnah bi Sunnah Fi'liya, by the action of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And because this practice continued and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw the Sahaba from the Iqrar al-Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, from his approval, this is Sunnah. So Taraweeh Sunnah from all these ways that you can say. Tayyib, how many rak'ah is Taraweeh? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, again we go back to Sahih al-Bukhari, he told us Salatul Layl, Mathna Mathna, that the night prayer is done in two and two. He didn't say 10 rak'ah, he didn't say 20, he didn't say 11, he didn't say 23. What did he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say? He says it's done in two and two. That's the only thing he told us. Yani if somebody prays less or more, there is no limit given to this. Unlike the sunan of Fajr or Dhuhr, or yani when you look at Jum'ah or any of these salawat, Rasulullah told us how many rak'at to pray in that. But here, Qiyamul Layl, whether in Ramadan or outside, he left it at, it's done two by two. What did Rasulullah do himself? We go back to Imam al-Bukhari Sahih in the same bab, the bab of Taraweeh. Aisha radiallahu anha, she was asked, innaha سأل عائشة رضي الله عنها كيف كانت صلاة الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في رمضان. So this is not about general قيام الليل. This is specifically about Ramadan. She was asked about that, and this is in the باب التراويح in Sahih al-Bukhari. فقالت فكان لا فكان يزيد في رمضان ولا في غيرها على 11 ركعة. He did not increase in Ramadan or outside of it more than 11 rak'at. In Ramadan and outside of it. Taraweeh or Qiyamul Layl, any time. Aisha radiyallahu anha in Sahih al-Bukhari, she has narrated that he did not make more than 11 rak'at. There is no Sahih hadith that can match, even come close to this, to say that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made 20 rak'at. What we know from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Sahih al-Bukhari, from an authentic hadith from Aisha radiyallahu anha, that his taraweeh, his qiyamul layl in Ramadan was 11 rak'at. Tayyib, so now the question comes to be, is making 20 rak'ah a bid'ah? No. Why? Because we go to the book Muwatta Imam Malik. And in the Muwatta Imam Malik, he has a bab, and it is the bab Kitab al-Salah fi Ramadan. Yani this is Qiyamul Layl for Ramadan, which is what we call Taraweeh. And in this bab, he has a number of ahadith. And I want to show these in order first. Just the order of the ahadith. Tayyib. The first hadith, which is hadith 253 here, it is reported from Imam Malik, from Muhammad ibn Yusuf, from Sahib ibn Yazid. Only these two links between him and Umar ibn Khattab. فأمر عمر بن خطاب رضي الله عنه أبي بن كعب وتميم الداري رضي الله عنهما أن يقوم للناس بأحد عشر ركعة. عمر رضي الله عنه, what did he do? He saw the people that they had separated. They were making salah by themselves. He gathered them behind أبي بن كعب and تميم الداري رضي الله عنهما. Like we have two imams taking turns here. He had the same way. He had these two imams leading. And he had them lead the people with 11 rak'at. Some people say Umar radiyan made 20 and he didn't do 11. The hadith is there in the same book before it. In the next hadith we find, which is 254, Umar radiyallahu anhu kana al-nas yaqoomu fi zaman Umar ibn Khattab fi Ramadan bi 23 rak'ah. He led the people with 23 rak'ah. The next hadith gives an explanation why between the two numbers. And that is that the Qari'a yaqra'a Surah Al-Baqarah fi thaman al-raka'at, in 8 raka'ah, they used to read all of Baqarah. So it became difficult on the people. Al-Hafidh ibn Abdul Barr al-Maliki, he said that what this means is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made 11 raka'ah. Abu Bakr's time, they made 11 rak'ah. In Umar radiallahu's time, they also made 11 rak'ah. He gathered the people in one jama'ah, as was done in the lifetime of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But when it became difficult, when it became too long for the older people, for the weaker people, then he increased the number of rak'ahs, so you would get breaks. And that's where the name Taraweeh came from. He made it 23 rak'ah because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say Taraweeh or Qiyamul Layl for Ramadan is 11 rak'ah or 10 or 23. He said mathna mathna, 2-2. So, looking at the condition of the people, Umar radiyallahu, he increased it to 23 rak'ah, and there's nothing wrong with that because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnati al-khulafa ar-rashidin al-mahdin. So what does that tell you? First thing, what is clear from the fi'l, qawl and iqrar al-Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, is making qiyamul layl in jama'ah, which is called taraweeh, is a sunnah. Second thing, the best way and the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and the only thing established from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam and from Abu Bakr and Umar is 11 rak'at. Whoever can do this, alhamdulillah, there is no problem with this. It's clear from Al-Bukhari and from the Muwatta Imam Malik that if Sahaba did it, nobody objected to it, great. If you see your community that it's hard on them to make long rak'at, if you increase it to 23 rak'ah, nothing wrong with that. All of the madhahib allowed it, nothing wrong with that. If you want to do more than that, like Imam Malik with 39 rak'ah and others, aqwal, nothing wrong with that, as long as you make it 2 by 2 and you end with witr with a single rak'ah. Tayyib? All of this is fine. If you do it, 11 rak'ah, this is the best. Why? Because this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, but they were long rak'ah. If you break it up, like in the later time of Umar and the Khilafah of Ali and Uthman and since then and what happened in the Haram till today, no problem with that, alhamdulillah, all of that is fine. Those that call each other mubtadi'a for doing this and some people that fight too much about this, this is out of ignorance, and we hope that in the light of these sahih ahadith, this issue is cleared up. Jazakumullahu khairan.